frozen in time on this massive cliff face are 5,000 footprints of terrifying prehistoric creatures. In a quarry in the highlands of Bolivia, a team of workers cut deep swaths into the fragile earth. Suddenly, though, their labor is interrupted by an amazing discovery. A set of ancient footprints is revealed, creeping up a near vertical wall. And the story of exactly what they are and how they eventually got there will blow your mind. The Bolivian capital of Sucre is an elegant colonial city located in the foothills of the Andes mountain range. With its pleasant climate and laid-back atmosphere, it's long been known as a place to escape the hustle and bustle of a sometimes hectic region. However, recent evidence has suggested that the area hasn't always been so peaceful. Indeed, back in 1985, a group of miners found traces of some incredible activity hidden within the very landscape itself. That year, Bolivian cement company Francesca had employed a group of miners to excavate a site some 3 miles outside the center of Sucre. But as they chipped away at the rock, they discovered mysterious footprints gouged into the quarry walls. As it turned out, the area around Sucre had been quite a hub of activity back when the layers of rock were formed millions of years ago. And the fearsome beasts that once roamed the land had certainly left their mark. Imprinted onto the cliffs around the quarry were the footprints of numerous dinosaurs. The site, known as Cal Orco, became renowned as a location of unique paleontological significance, and even today its riddles are still being unlocked. But although some footprints were first discovered in the mid-1980s, serious study of the site did not begin until 1994. Subsequently, researchers realized the full extent of the discovery, and what a discovery it was. Yes, at Cal Orco they found a massive limestone wall almost 4,000 feet in length, stretching up over 250 feet from the quarry floor. Its surface was covered in more than 5,000 prehistoric footsteps. Then, in 1998, paleontologist Christian Meyer from the Natural History Museum of Basel, Switzerland, brought a team of researchers to the site. For 2 months, they studied the relics, eventually concluding that they were representing the largest collection of dinosaur footprints found anywhere in the world. Covering an area of 269,100 square feet, the site boasts footprints from almost 300 different species of dinosaur, including one thought to have stood more than 80 feet tall. The biggest footprint, meanwhile, is almost 3 feet in length. Dating from approximately 65 million years ago, the trails offer a fascinating insight into the lives and habitats of the dinosaurs that once inhabited this region. There's no comparable site in the world, Meyer told the local press. Among the dinosaurs represented at the site are the Carnotaurus, a carnivorous dinosaur with almost ridiculously small limbs, and the Ankylosaurus, an armored plant eater with a club tail. There are also footprints from a gargantuan herbivore known as a Titanosaur, which would have weighed in at more than 100 tons. Additionally, Cal Orco is home to the longest set of dinosaur tracks ever discovered. Reaching almost 1,150 feet in length, they were in fact left by a young Tyrannosaurus Rex that researchers have dubbed Johnny Walker. Alongside the footprints, moreover, researchers have also found dinosaur bones and indicators that fish and crocodiles once inhabited the area. Consequently, this led them to theorize that Cal Orco was at one time a lake where dinosaurs would come to drink and bathe. Experts believe that damp weather caused the dinosaurs' feet to leave imprints on the soft ground, which then hardened when drier weather came. This cycle then repeated itself, allowing numerous layers of footprints to form. Then, at some point in the region's geological history, tectonic activity caused the landscape to change. The horizontal piece of rock where dinosaurs had once walked shifted into a near vertical position, creating the uncanny impression of footprints lodged at an impossible location. Today, Cal Orco is a popular tourist destination. In 2006, in fact, the Parque Cretáceo Museum opened on the site, using models and special effects to tell the story of dinosaurs that once lived in the region. What's more, a viewing platform offers visitors the chance to observe the footprints still lodged in the quarry walls. Interestingly though, Cal Orco is still a work in progress. Ongoing industrial development activities at the site, as well as natural geological processes, mean that new landscapes are constantly being revealed. It's just amazing, guide Maria Teresa Gamon told The Guardian in 2011. We see fresh footprints and fossils all the time. We lose some, we find some, it's always changing. In April of 2015, furthermore, Quarrying work extended to a new area of the site, and researchers made another amazing discovery: 5,000 new footprints, including two sets belonging to a previously unknown species. And while the excavators and trucks continue to pick their way through the ancient rock, who knows what other wonders are waiting to be revealed.